Good evening, everybody. First, we introduce ourselves. As I said in the morning, I'm Nava Sonnenschein. I'm the director of the School for Peace.
Good evening. I am Harb Amara. I'm School for Peace.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Amir Fakhouri. The head of our research center.
Hi, I'm happy to meet you again. I'm Dr. Roy Silberberg. I'm a programs director in the School for Peace, and I want to say thank you for being engaged.
I want to share with you about what we do in the School for Peace, what our goals, what we did last year, what we plan to do coming year. And we are very busy today in a process of constructing. The School for Peace is seeing the main resource of the School for Peace is our human capital. This is how you call it, Amir. Our graduates. In the last 14 years, we have trained thousands of adult people in three programs, the university courses that we do, the change agent programs we do for different professional groups, and facilitator training courses where we train people to be facilitators of groups in conflict. We want to create a network that will give our graduates opportunity to develop equality inside our country and peace between us and the Palestinians. We invest a lot of efforts, time, resources in developing this model. We learn from other experiences of creating such a network, and even this year, with the help of a family foundation in Holland, with the help of the Dutch friends of Neve Shalom Wachat Salam, we start a pilot project in this field with three group, professional groups. One is the mental health professionals, the other one is planners and architects, and the other one is leaders in mixed towns. Later you will hear also from graduates from those courses. The idea is to choose about 400 people, the cream of our graduates from the thousands, maybe we will have more, that we will invest in them, in the politicians, in the journalists, in all different groups we have worked with, to help to get out from this freezing political situation and in struggles to bring equality and justice and peace between the two people owning this state. Recently, we submitted the German government a proposal to activate our 80 graduates from the courses we do for planners and urban planners, architects and civil engineers. It's a project that we are doing together with the Arab Center for Alternative Planning to activate them to fight against the tendency of the Israeli government to annex Area C. Annexation is not at one point, it's a gradual process. And planners have the ability to spy, to see what is going on, and to submit papers against it and to activate the international community against this act. Because if they annex Area C, which is 60% of the West Bank, there is no chance for a Palestinian state. Nothing is left there. So almost nothing. As for the ongoing activities of the, activity of this School for Peace, we will continue our courses for facilitators, for young lawyers to become lawyers of human rights, to leaders in mixed cities. And we are creating now new courses for media people who have enormous role in inciting or advancing peace. Depends what training they get here. Roy developed a course, and he will talk about it, about uniting between different struggles. Because each group is struggling separately. We want to do an Arab-Jewish course for change agents, for people from different struggles in gender, refugees, Arab, Jewish, whatever. Another new course is for archaeologists. Why archaeologists? Because we have, today, they are using archaeology to annex and to destroy houses of Palestinians with the excuse that under their houses there are archaeological treasures. Our research center is developing, and Amir will talk about it. We have plans to do a project that will bring both sides, influential people, to negotiate the future character of the state or the future democratic constitution, like principles of constitution inside Israel, and we hope also in Palestine. We have now, last week, we opened four courses in Israeli universities, Haifa, Tel Aviv, and Ben-Gurion, and Rupin College. We are also thinking about opening a chapter for the School for Peace in the north of the country, because we have most of the Palestinian citizens of Israel live in the north. Our graduates are interested to develop such a chapter, and we will be able to advance more college and university courses in the north, and to work also with Arab teenagers to reduce the to create education for values, hoping to reduce the level of violence inside the Arab community. Another goal that we have is to offer professionals in our community to develop courses in their profession. One of them is for theater players and directors of theater, because Imad Jabarin is an actor and he's a new member in the community. Gidon Suleimani, who is an architect, archaeologist, is developing the course for archaeologists. So we are trying to include more and more people in our community to develop courses. We are also thinking about developing more our literature teachers together with Professor Yigal Schwartz, who is a member of our community, now not living here, but he's the head of a literature department in Ben-Gurion University. It is really important for us to do cooperation with other NGOs that our goals and their goals are similar. The Israeli left shrank in the last maybe 20 years since the Rabin assassination, and we think we should cooperate where it is possible. Today we met with one organization that is called the Two States, One Homeland Group. We have amazing cooperation with the Arab Center for Alternative Planning. Each year we do a course for planners with them. We have a cooperation with Van Leer and with IDEA. We started to work. We started cooperation with Notre Dame University in Indiana in the United States, and with Lucerne University in Switzerland. So cooperation is important. Not each of NGOs should work separately and compete about sources of money. We started to do also consultation for other Jewish Arab NGOs. We are doing now for two of them, and we think there will be more. In the last year, we had four courses in university. We finished the third course for up and coming politicians. Altogether, it was across the border with Palestinians from Palestine, with an organization called INMA, and we intend to work with the the up and coming politicians in our network, and we hope they will. Some of them climbed. Really, you have the 2018 annual report of the School for Peace, so you can see what positions they got to and how high they climbed the ladder. We have one mayor or several deputy mayors of towns, and the head of peace now is our graduates. Wherever you go in peace and human rights organization, you will find our graduates. Recently, I discovered that in BIMCOM, it's another organization of planners, four board members are our graduates. We conducted four conferences by the research center. Amir will talk about it. We also, now the main thing that we have is our amazing staff. It's four of us and Bob Fenton, who is sitting there, and Faten Abu Ghosh, who is our secretary, and Rina is a housekeeper. It's a small staff, but a lot of work. And all the 20, 30, freelance facilitators who come and facilitate and manage those change agent courses. We invest quite a lot in grant proposal writing. Some of them are accepted. We were lucky in the last 3 years. Two of them were accepted with the amazing work that Bob Fenton is doing for us. We succeeded with the USAID, and then Trump stopped the grant in the middle. And I must say that the Friends Association really picked it up, not the same amount, but enabled us to finish the courses that we wanted to do. You asked one question, what are the challenges that we are facing? The growing movement of anti-normalization in Palestine is one of the obstacles. Recruiting participants is becoming more difficult than in the past. Most Israelis don't want to meet with Palestinians. And also most of the Palestinians see it as normalization. So how do you... So we have to invest several months to recruit the people to our programs. The competition over funding, recently we submitted the British Embassy a proposal they really wanted to get, and we didn't get it. It was one of seven. So sometimes we will send you proposals that were not accepted, and you will find other resources for those proposals. We have goals for the five coming years. One is to establish the active network of School for Peace graduates and broaden the change agent program to include new professional groups and to increase the number of colleges and universities, to establish the satellite of School for Peace in the North, to transform Fred Segal Peace Library, where we sit. He's still alive, and he's still supportive, and we will do here an incubator for initiating creative, not high-tech incubator, but initiating programs to advance peace and equality. And we want also to advance our say in the Israeli and Palestinian society, especially in Israel, by the conferences that we do. We did one after the nation state law in the Center for Advanced Studies in Hebrew University, and to advance cooperation between the Israeli left and the Arab party. Now, what we expect from you guys, other than this financial support, we would like you to really initiate conferences like the Swiss Friends of Neve Shalom did around the books that we publish. Yesterday, I got from Jenny Nemko. She wrote a review on the book, and she will publish it in newspaper. If we have graduates in your country, you can ask them to speak for you in events. We have graduates all over, also in Europe and in North America. And to keep your energy going so we can continue this enormous work. So thank you very much. And tomorrow you have a program, but you have to know that tomorrow we have two programs running at the School for Peace. So you can jump to look a little. One is for the course for lawyers that Amir and Meital are managing, and they will have an interesting panel at what hour? 10:30? Quarter to 10, so you can come and observe a little bit behind the one-way mirror, and you will get a translation if you do so. And we have the facilitator training course that Roi and Maya Rabia are doing, so you can come and look a little bit and go to your sessions. Establish the active network of graduates. Broaden the change agent program, more profession, more groups. Increase the number of colleges and universities that we work with. Now we have a contact with Bar Ilan. It's good. This religious, more right-wing university. Establish the satellite in the chapter in the north. Transform this library, peace library. We don't have the college, but we will have an incubator for creating new projects by our graduates, and conducting research conferences and developing policy papers on issues of shared society, two-state solution, equality and justice. These are the goals for the 5 years. So now we move to... let's keep the questions to the end. This is one state for the two people. The people have to understand that it's not a Jewish state. It's a state for the citizens that are living here. We have to share resources, seats in the government, seats in the parliament, to see the Palestinians as partners as us for the future of this country. This is a message we are working. And with the Palestinians, West Bank and Gaza, so they should have their own state that will live in peace and will become equal to the Israeli state. So these are the ideological goals of the school. We know that we are small, we are not big. Our budget is about 3 million shekel, but we can do much more. And we see that if we didn't work all those 40 years, you couldn't find in all these peace and human rights organizations those activists.
Good evening. I am Harba Amara, project director to the School for Peace. I started 5 years ago to work in School for Peace and staff. I want to tell you about the project, what Roy and Nava develop, about how we can work and push the activities of participant who took courses here in the School for Peace and want to work and develop projects in their society, people to people. My intention that we want to work with a change agent that they took a courses and to build with them a community for a change agent. To do the change with her community, her city, her professional, what we want to do, the first step, we ask the participant about if they change and if they want to do something to finish the conflict. What we found out most participants said they had a better understanding of the other and they were more positive towards the other and said that they were willing to work with the other on shared interests. Step two, we are going to organize alumni meetings in December. We meet the planners, the change agent, mental health professional change agent, leaders mixed city change agent. We have at least 100 participants. From each professional. Step three, we will teach them how to think and do projects together. We support ideas and the project execution to finish the conflict and support shared society. Step four, building an alumni network that will form the base for alumni work and support. We hope that work will be make change in their society and make the change in the country and to live in a fair and just society that care for all its members. Thank you for listening.
Thanks for Nava and Harb. I could not feel very proud to hear how much busy we've been, especially Nava. And thank you again for your engagement and your support to us. My name is Amir. I'm a lawyer, a scholar. I'm currently completing my PhD in cultural and political sociology. I am a scholar on the fields of nationalism and ethnicity. I write a lot in mainstream media about trying to project our ideas. Nava called it what they called it. I call it, in a very brief way, liberal co-nationalism. As the head of the co-nationalism, as the head of the research center, when people ask us why do Neve Shalom needs a research center, it's in English, it's not in Hebrew. Why Neve Shalom Wahti Salam needs a research center, I simply answer that agents needs ideation. Without ideations, agents cannot be effective enough. They need a proper cognitive scheme of reality. They need to develop a sense of location, a sense of location in a current political movement. They have to know they are not alone. They have to know how to collaborate with others from their camp. They have to know how to build a camp. So we look at, because we understand that we have a moral, historical obligation to not only to be a beacon of what I called co-nationalism, peaceful liberal co-nationalism. We have to project that from our meso level as an NGO to the macro political system. This is why we've brought to here leading politicians from the left Zionist camp and from the joint list or the Arab politicians to try and influence them or try to inspire them and providing them the tools, the political grammar, how to build a camp. By the way, our next big research project is called Finding Political Grammar. We, as you probably know, we're in the midst of a historical moment, especially after the two last elections, more and more Jewish from the left, Israeli Jews from the left are realizing the political importance and the political potential of partnership, of partnering with the Arab Palestinians. I think it's a mutual process. So we want to harness this moment, to channel this political sentiment, to try to buttress and booster this this political sentiment to until it gives fruits. And we know that after 70 years of non-collaboration, the actors, while having the sentiment, the intuition that they have to partner up, lacks grammar, they lacks ideology. They lack the ability to justify their sentiment, both internally to their audience and externally to other masses. So we understand our role not only to train agents but also to provide them with ideation. So this is what we try to do. We're gonna do in the project about political grammar. We did in the international conference that Nava told you about. We're talking about the whole pack of discourse, metaphors, moral philosophy that can enables you to think if we can agree that your language and your consciousness is interrelated, so we provide the language, the ability to. I work a lot with politicians. I closely work with politicians, and I see the difference between intuition, like a feel for the game. Sociologists call it a feel for the game, and having a reflected, accurate political grammar. You need that. So we're trying to advance on that level. Trying to project to the upper level, to the macro political system, working with politicians. This is what we did around our book, a book that I edited last year called Potential Alliances. And we brought, again, main leaders. This is what we're doing now with one of the biggest research institute in the state, Van Leer Institute. Around political grammar, this is what we're doing around the constitution, trying to find what is the flag of this camp. Would it be the liberal flag? Would it be the democratic flag? Would it be the binational flag? What flag this camp? We know that the right camp has a flag, and mainly based on anti-Arab, anti-Palestinian sentiment. But what is the flag of those who are left to the right? What flag can they rally around? This is the main obstacle of this. They know that they are not the right, but they don't know what is positively bring them together. What flag can initiate can the sufficient motivation to become politically effective? And so we're trying to answer this question and to provide them with the tools, how to think about it, how to frame it, first of all, and how to provide answers to it at the end. I think that the first level of a good ideation should start with framing. Framing what is the problems? What? So, our philosophy as a shared society, this place being an embodiment of a shared society, should be wielded, should be used in order to project to the agents at the micro level, and to the politicians and institution at the macro level. So this is the moral, historical, political. Role of the shared society to not only to be to work as an island in Israel, but to enlarge that island to the whole. It will, of course, it will be done gradually because of the structural constraints that you are all familiar with, but it should be projected systematically with agents and ideation, with the field and theory, with the theory and the field intertwined. One step in the field, one step in the ideation, in a very dialectical way. There is no theory without work in the field, and there is no work without theory. You have to work intimately, to advance intimately in the two steps. Finally, we're now working on our conference book about the nationality, what is known as the basic law, Israel as the nation state of the Jewish people. We're now working on publishing our conference book. We're very excited about that. We have hosted 16 experts on the subject that spoke about that, and this will be the part of our input and contribution to the field in what concerns ideation. Tomorrow we will host a panel titled Initiation, Planning and Executing in the Civil Society, because the second part of our agent change agent course is providing them tools how to be activists, how to take a simple abstract idea and to write a proposal, to find the donor. So tomorrow this will be the theme of the panel. Thank you again.
I want to repeat one of the ideas that Amir mentioned, and I saw it got a good response, but I feel it really give a direction to all of our doing. And there were some questions before about goals and all that. So the village is a very important place here. It's an oasis, it's a neve, a waha. And I really appreciate that you, for many years, supported it. We see the work of the School for Peace as a way to, Amir called it, to project what is going on, that this waha will have an influence on what is going on. And we are really in a desert. I think that the understanding of the situation outside really highlights our actions, really leading our actions, because we are really working our minds on what is the best way to take our understanding and the alternative that is built and being shown here to the outside. And I will say two examples, like Nava mentioned. I will talk about the youth workshops, and I will talk about the you call it uniting struggles. There is a slogan, one struggle, one fight. So maybe we'll call it one struggle, one fight, change agents course. But before that, I will say that there were so many activities that were mentioned here, and so many change agents courses, for example, which I cannot even remember all of them just from by heart. And it's not a small thing that you're counting. There is one, there is two, there is three. No. Each one of these courses are very involved, and there is a huge investment. It's not only, let's say, for the entire year, there are 15 or 16 full activity days. There's just, for example, recruiting those people, the participants. We put in more resources on this stage than the course itself, for example, or let's say half. The preparation phase is half of the investment, which because of the desert that I mentioned before. So this is something that we should take into account when we put the cards, ta, 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 like that. Each one of these is something very big. And I will talk very briefly on the youth workshops. I think people who know us, they know a lot about the youth workshops. They're going on for 40 years. But as I wanted to say that we need to understand the desert, which is outside, I feel goosebumps when I say it, but there is a huge problem in the education system here for Jews and for Arabs. It is indoctrinizing, if we can say that. It's very militaristic. It needs to see an alternative. It needs to see our alternative. I will say a short story today. My partner, she went through a medical diagnostic operation, but it was under anesthesia. When she came out, she was really in a high. She was under drugs. And she told me, oh, sweetheart, I really recommend it. This is the feeling our facilitators and some of the participants leave a youth workshop. And this, they are pressuring me to say, we must have more. And I told this to Deborah yesterday, to Deb, that we have an idea of making this of going into a process of making this kind of youth workshop possible for every school in Israel. This is like a vision of us, something that we think it should be possible. Okay, so it will require a lot of funding, but not only, it will require many, many things. And this is one of the visions that we have. And it is from the point of view of how to best influence what is going on in society using what we built here. The second thing I will talk about is the One Struggle, One Fight Change Agents course. And I will also use one of Amir's ideas that he mentioned, is that there is a problem in civil society. And there is a problem in, and I'm not the smartest guy to talk about it. I know it from experience, but other people are talking about it. That the different struggles in the progressive movements wants to influence and to exert change, they are sporadic, and they are not synergistic, if you can, if there is a word like that. And the idea behind behind this came from listening to Dov Hanin, which is an ex Knesset member from the Communist Party, if you can say, or the Hadash Party, that is talking about different ways to unite the progressive forces. And we thought about that, okay, there are the different struggles, but we can add another dimension to it, because the different civil societies and struggles in the Arab society and in the Jewish society are almost separate. You can say that maybe they're going through same struggles, but in parallel, don't meet. And this is the idea, is to bring here to a change agents course activists from different struggles. It could be the struggle for the refugees. It could be struggles against violence, against violence against women. It could be for the environment, or there are many. There are many struggles, and to bring them to one course and to go through a long process in order to find what is shared between those struggles and how we can work together.
What, if any, approach have you had, and has it been successful, or has it been rejected by the Ministry of Education?
It's a very complicated question with a long history, and I will just say that there was an attempt to cooperate with this, with similar kind of an activity by Givat Chaviva, which they did a different youth program, which was, let's say, more suitable for the Ministry of Education, and it was kind of robust, let's say 25 meetings a year, maybe 50 schools a year. It's still not universal, but it's big. But they were, I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't want to do such a youth workshop because of that it shaped according to the pressures of the Ministry of Education. I will not detail the influences, how it influenced the workshop, but it's something that, as it is now and how the desert is looking, this is not the way I would go through, which causes a huge problem. Such an endeavor is an endeavor fitting for a ministry. I will say it. It's something that fits a ministry.
One example of a Palestinian teacher of literature who changed the term the Zionist enemy in textbooks in Palestine, in a Ministry of Education in Palestine. And we have two teachers who offered the Ministry of Education a curriculum about teaching the poems of the other side. So we have examples of how they succeeded even though the Ministry of Education was in the hand of the national religious, and there is a process of hadata, making the schools more national religious. Some things are succeeding in this way.
And the program for teachers.
Yeah, yeah, of course. We want to renew this program. We worked in the history with several peace NGOs in Palestine. The last one was INMA. Before that was Tawassul. Before that was Khiwar. Now we are working with the Tuna. The next proposal in the German government is with the Tuna. But we have colleagues who didn't have an organization but worked with us since 93, and we like to work with them, and we do good work with them, no matter under what organization they are, and they decided to create their own organization, which is the Tuna.
Do you see any impact on the School for Peace with the current political elements and election possibilities, etc.? Will that have, do you anticipate that that has any impact on the program that you've just described or talked about?
One answer is that one of our graduates is Samer Swade. He's the director of the Arab Center for Alternative Planning. He did a campaign to bring the Arab voters to the poll, and as a result of it, they got 13 seats instead of 10 seats in the parliament. So this is one impact on society, very important one.
A few years ago, we heard from School for Peace that after decades of arranging people-to-people encounters, that you were changing your strategy a bit more to work with change agents, with the idea that each person you touched would be more leveraged and would touch a lot of people themselves. And it's very, you know, exciting to hear about this idea about universal encounters. It's like something you would dream of when you woke up from anesthesia. But is the idea that the, you know, the wave sort of washed out is now washing back in, because you had moved away from that, it seemed.
We moved away not because we don't believe in those encounters for youth, but because we didn't have funding and we had to do priority where the impact is higher. They are costly because you need to residential program, and that's why we did less, but not because, as Roy said, we want to impact this desert that is existing in Israeli schools, and this is one way to impact, to work with teachers and students.
I love the image of the desert and the oasis. How do we get the stories? I mean, you mentioned just one about the Arab and the Bodhi. How do we get a list of stories that we can tell from a personal level?
So first you have the book with 25 stories. Yeah, so use the stories. And next we will have a panel of several people telling you about the process of change they have gone through and what they did with it. We are trying to collect all those stories, and with a request, we will send you more stories. One more question from Switzerland.
Well, first of all, I hope that we have another opportunity to discuss, because your project raised a number of questions which are really highly interesting, so I just want to address one here. And I hope that we have an opportunity to fill these 3 days to discuss. You mentioned many times the difficulty, the deserts, the difficulty of recruiting and so on. And I agree this is a real part of the work. Could you please tell more about how you recruit if I can such a way? People who don't want.
Look, 3 years ago, we got money from the EU, €500,000, to recruit 120 up-and-coming politicians. It's not just you publish everywhere. So we had to go to heads of parties to ask them who do they think have the bigger chances to get to the parliament in 5, 10 years. Then we went to interview them. Many refused, but some agreed. We use, with other profession, we use networks, and we use our graduates to help us to recruit other people. But it's a tedious process, name by name. When we get three CVs in one day, it's a big celebration. So this is a process. We invest 3 months at least to recruit a new group of change agent. So it's an enormous work to invest. Now me and Harb are recruiting journalists. We spread it in all journalist networks. We didn't get yet, we got two CVs in a week. So it's, we call people, ask them to recommend their colleagues. We send networks of professionals. I hope we will have another time to discuss more, but this is what we have.